Once again, welcome. Oh, we are dealing with this first problem on a 3-inch circular arch. We found the reactions, we found the thrust that supports A and B. Then reactions at the crown by considering the free body diagram of the CB portion. Now we are dealing bending moment at 6 meters from left hand hinge. That is 6 meters from left hinge. That is M6 will be equal to VA into 6, it is sagging. Then 16 is the load into 6 minus 4 into HA into Y6. This Y6 we are discussing to find. That is from the geometry. Y6 will be 3.8 meters. That is 1 minus cos theta. Theta we know here. Theta will be 8 minus 6 by r. And we can find Y6. It is 9.6 kilonewton meter sagging. Now, the last part of the question is to find the maximum bending moment. It is true, maximum bending moment will occur under the load, that is at a distance of 4 meters, that is here. Under the load means here will be the maximum bending moment, and maximum bending moment at this 4 meters can be calculated. As usual, by considering this under the load, 16 kilonewton. This is A, this is 4 meter. Now we require this as Y16 kilonewton. At this distance, what is this? The bending moment under the load is due to this HA and VA and this 16 kilonewton. Therefore, M bending moment under 16 kilonewton will be equal to VA. About this point, it will try to bend the beam like this, that is sagging. Therefore, plus 16, sorry, this VA, sagging means plus VA into 4 meters. The line of action of VA is along this line. Therefore, the perpendicular distance is this. That is 4 beta. Because load is at a distance of 4 meter from A. That is given in the question. Therefore, VA into 4, it is sagging plus. Now, HA, about this point, HA is bending the arch in this way. That is convexity upward. Therefore, it is sagging. Therefore, minus, it is HA into Y at 16 kilonewton. That is VA is 12 kilonewton into 4 minus HA is 8 into Y 16 kilonewton. Now for this, from the geometry of the figure, Y 16 can be found, and it is this Y under 16 kilonewton or Y at X is equal to 4 meter. Now sine theta 4, that is, will be 8 minus 4 by R. Yeah. This is 4 meter. This, I will come to the PPT only. Here, 4 meter, that is under 16 kilonewton. Here, theta can be calculated using this. 8 minus 4 divided by R, 23.58 degrees. Therefore, Y4 will be, this Y4 will be H minus R, R cos theta. That is 3.16 meter from the geometry. Therefore, this maximum bending moment will be this Y, 3.16 is Y6. We will get the maximum bending moment in kilonewton meter. That's all there is about this problem. Now, we'll see one more problem. That is, again, circular arch. A 3-inch circular arch consists of a portion AC of radius 3 meter. This will be the center, 3 meter. This is one arc of a circle, and radius of the inch is 3 meter. This the right hand portion CB is of radius 8 meter. This will be the arc of the circle. Radius is 8 meter. And the horizontal distance between C and B, this is 7 meter. We should write the figure carefully. We should transfer this problem into a figure carefully. 7 meter is the horizontal distance. If a concentrated load of 10 kilonewton acts at 6 meter, 10 kilonewton acts at 6 meter from left end, this is 6 meter. That means this is the 3 meter crown inch. Therefore, it is beyond or to the right of C. Determine the reaction at the hinges. That is, at A, HA and VA. At B, HB and VB. And maximum positive body moment on the arch. It is very clear. Maximum positive body moment. If a structure is subjected to a point load, point loads will be under the point loads. But here only one point load, therefore it is absolute. Maximum positive body moment will be under 10 kilonewton. We'll come to that later. First we'll find the reactions. Okay. First, if you apply sigma fx is equal to 0, plus HA minus HB is equal to 0, because no other horizontal forces are acting. That is plus HA minus HB. VA, VB, 10 kilonewton will not come into sigma FX condition. From this, HA is equal to HB. Call this equation number 1. Then applying sigma fy is equal to 0. I take upward force component positive, downward curve force component as negative. In that, if you apply, VA is acting up, plus VA minus 10 kilonewton, that is the external load, plus VB is equal to 0. That means VA plus VB is equal to 10 kilonewton. Let us call that equation number 2. HA and HB will not come into the sigma FY condition. Now, next condition is sigma MA is equal to 0. We take clockwise moment positive, anti-clockwise moment negative. About A, if we are taking, considering the whole arch, HA is acting at A for no perpendicular distance, no moment. Therefore, zero. VA is also acting at A, no perpendicular distance because it is acting at A. Therefore, VA also creates zero moment. It is zero. Then this 10 kilonewton about A, this 10 kilonewton causing a moment like this, causing a moment like this, it is clockwise. Therefore, 10 into its perpendicular distance, this is the line of action of 10 kilonewton and A perpendicular distance. Therefore, 10 into 6 plus. That is plus 10 into 6. Then HB, I'll come to that later. VB, about A, VB creates a moment like this. About A. It is anti-clockwise. Therefore, minus VB into its perpendicular distance is this horizontal distance between A and B. It is 7 plus this 3. Totally, because line of action is here. Line of action of VB is this. Therefore, this distance will be 7 plus 3, 10. That is minus VB into 10. Then HB about A, it creates a moment like this, the line of action. It goes like this and turn like this. It is clockwise plus HB into its distance. Now its distance we should be careful. That is HB line of action is here. You see here. The perpendicular distance of HB from A means this distance. You see carefully this distance. Little geometry is involved here. It is true if you consider this right angle triangle by Pythagoras theorem, this height will be 8 square hypotenuse square minus 7 square, that is 3.87. But we want this. That distance will be R, this distance I want. To calculate this distance, this is 3 from C to A, vertical distance. Therefore, let us, this 3 should be deducted from year to year, and this can be calculated as, that is from year B to C, vertical distance. B to C vertical distance will be 8. That is, this is radius. You see, this is the radius. From C to this, it is 8 meter. 8 minus this, we get the height of C from B level. You're understanding, you know? That will be 8 minus 3.87, 4.13 meter. That means from B level to C level, 4.13. Therefore, this will be the perpendicular distance of HB from A. It will be 4.13 minus 3. That is 4 point. That is HB. We found HB is causing clockwise. HB is nothing but H into 4.13 minus 3. It's the perpendicular distance is equal to 0. From this, 10 VB minus, this will be 4.13 minus 3 will be 1.13 HB or H will be equal to this 10 into 6, 60. If you rearrange, that is equation number 3. From these 3 equations, there will be 4 unknowns we cannot solve. Therefore, applying another equilibrium condition, we know sigma MC is equal to 0. While applying sigma MC, you should consider free body diagram of the arch. To the left of C or to the right of C, as discussed in the previous problem. If you consider left side, it will be easy because only HA and VA are active. If you consider right side, HB, VB and 10 also will come into picture. Why to go? Unnecessary one more term, etc. Extra. Therefore, let us consider the portion AC. If you consider AC, about C, if you take the moment, HA is causing like this, it is anti-clockwise minus HA into its distance is this 3. And VA creates clockwise, therefore plus VA into the line of action of this VA is this, this 3 will be the perpendicular distance. Therefore, if you apply sigma MC is equal to 0, minus 3 into 3 plus VA into 3 is equal to 0. HA is equal to VA. Call this equation number 4. Now solving the above equations. This is H. If you substitute VA, H, we get VB is equal to minus H. VB is equal to 10 minus that. That, if you substitute here in place of VB, 10 minus H or HB or HA, whatever it is, we get HA and VA. All the reactions we can calculate by solving those 4 equations. It is simple mathematics. That is VA we get 3.59, VB get 6.41, H is equal to 3.59 kilonewton. Now we can calculate the resultant reaction also. At A, we got HA and VA. At B we got HB and VB. The arch is here. Here, resultant reaction RA can be calculated as, oh sorry, this is HA. VA square plus HA square under square root. VA we have calculated as 3.59 square plus HA is nothing but HB, nothing but H, 3.59 whole square. Resultant reaction, we get 5.08 kilonewton. Similarly, inclination of the resultant with horizontal, this alpha A, can be calculated as tan inverse VA by HA, that is tan inverse VA. It is 3.59, no, VA is 3.59 divided by HA is 3.59, both are same. That means tan inverse of 1, it is the 45 degrees. Similarly, at B, the resultant reaction RB can be calculated using the equation VB square plus HB square under square root. VB we know 6.41 square plus HB is 3.59 square under square root. And we get RB as 8.94 kilonewton. Similarly, if the inclination of RB with horizontal is alpha B, it can be calculated as alpha B is equal to tan inverse of VB by HB. It will be, after substitution, 60.5 degrees. That's what the answers which are given here. That is the first part of the question, finding the support reactions at A and B. Now they asked you to find maximum bending moment. We know maximum bending moment occurs under the loads. Under the loads, point loads. Here, arch is subjected to only one point load, which is at 6 meters from the left end. Correct? Yeah. Therefore, maximum bending moment occur under this 10 kilonewton load. Now, bending moment at this point can be calculated by considering right side or left side of the beam. You consider left side, so much calculation. Therefore, let us consider right side of this point load and calculate the bending moment. Now, this is the arch. It was as that is under the 10 kilonewton is the maximum bending moment. Yeah. This is C, say, crown. This is the arch. It is 8 meter radius. B, that is HB and VB, we have established. Now this distance is very important. Now bending moment is maximum here. Therefore M under 10 kilonewton can be calculated by considering right side. The forces which are responsible for the bending moment are HB and VB. VB like this acting, therefore it is about this point, it is trying to bend the arch in this way, sagging, because convexity downward, therefore plus VB into its distance is this, because line of action is here. This distance, it is given from A, this 10 kilonewton is at 6 meter. That is from A, some area. A. Full is 3. Therefore, if you continue this, this will be 3 meter, correct? Because this is 3. It is given A to C is 3 meter. 6 meter means from C to point load, it is 3 meter. And if you draw this, this is the radius. This is 8 meter means this is the radius. Therefore, this is also 8 meter. Little more geometry is involved here. And the horizontal distance between C and B is 7 meter. That we know. It is given in the starting itself. Therefore, VB distance here will be this distance horizontal. How much is this? This is 7, this is 3, therefore this distance will be 7 minus 3, 4, that is VB into 4, simple. HB is acting like this, therefore it is arch, trying to fold like this, that means it is like this. Convexity like this, convexity upward, that is hugging, minus HB is minus, that is hugging into its perpendicular distance, it is this. Now it is a geometry. We have to find this perpendicular, this distance. Now, if you take this as O, height of the load above this distance. Carefully. This distance. From this right angle triangle, it is 8 square minus 3 square under square root. It is 7.42 meter. Careful. Height of the point load 10 kilonewton above this distance. Height of B above O, that means this distance. This. Height of B. Height of the load above B. Height of the load above B. This distance. Sorry. This distance. This distance. Nothing but this distance. It is 8 square minus 7 square. 8 square minus 7 square. This is 7. This one. Got it? 8, height of B above O, that means this distance, is nothing but this distance. From this right angle triangle, again Pythagoras theorem, radius is 8, this is 7, therefore this will be 8 square minus 7 square under square root. It is 3.55. Therefore, height of load above B, this distance will be, this distance will be full, that is 7.42 minus 3.55. Sorry, 8 square minus 7 square, it is 3.87. 3.87. Therefore, this is 3.55. is equal to, you can calculate the bending moment. VB we know as 6.41, calculated. HB we know 3.59. If you calculate, any moment we get is 12.9 kilonewton meter. That is any moment. Maximum bending, that is 12.9 kilonewton meter. We have to do little geometry here. Should be careful. No other go for the calculation of this height, 10 HB, and this distance. Okay, everything is given here. That is This another circular arch with support points at different levels. Now we'll come to parabolic arches. Parabolic arches, equation of the parabola, it is very important. That is y is equal to 4hx l minus x divided by l squared. That equation. In the circular analysis, that is different. Radius, other things will come. Here, the equation of the parabola we should remember to solve the numerical problems. Now coming to the problems. It is a parabolic arch hinged at the springings and crown has a span of 20 meter. This is one point A springing. This is B another point springing. The distance between these two supports is 20 meter. The central rise is 4 meter. That is nothing but the crown hinge position with respect to the springings. 4 meter central rise. Now it is loaded with UDL, uniformly distributed load, of 2 kilonewton per meter on the left 8 meter length. This is 8 meter length. It will come some area. Because full span is 20, half span will be 10. Almost 3/4 of the span is loaded with UDL. Calculate the magnitude and direction of reactions at the hinges. That means HA, VA, HB, VB, and also RA at A and RB at B. Nothing but thrust or resultant reactions due to HA and VA at A, due to HB and VB at B. Reactions at the hinges. That is one part of the question. Just by applying equilibrium condition. Then normal thrust and radial shear at 4 meter and 15 meter from left end. Two points they ask you to find the normal thrust and radial shear. In the previous two problems, it was asked to find only at one point. Now it is at two points, left end, that is 4 meter, it will be some area, and 15 meter, it is on the other side of the crown, it is here. Maximum positive and negative bending moment. No doubt, maximum bending moment will be under the loads, here under UDL. Where we have to find it. We know the answers. In shear force and bending moment diagram of strength of materials, we have discussed to find the maximum bending moment. In the same way, we have to find, we'll come to that later, just like beam moment. Positive and negative bending moment. Negative bending moment will occur in the unloaded portion here, where it is not loaded. And hence, bending moment diagram. It is asked to draw bending moment diagram also. Be clear? Converting this problem into a figure. A 3-inch parabolic arch, A, B, C, 3 inches, 20 meter apart. C is at 4 meter height, that is but rise. Subjected to UDL of 8 kilonewton meter, 2 kilonewton meter, for a length of 8 meter. Task to find reactions, normal thrust and radial shear at D and E. Now, let HA and VA are the horizontal and vertical reaction at A. HB and VB are the horizontal and vertical reaction set. B. Now, sigma fx is equal to 0. HA plus HA minus HB is equal to 0. Nothing but HA is equal to HB, or let us say H. Because here, this VA will not come into sigma FY calculation, VB also, and UD also, because it is a vertical load. It is horizontal force condition. For only HA and HB will come into the equation. Then applying sigma FY is equal to 0 by considering as usual upward force positive, downward force negative. That is plus VA plus VB minus, we know this UDL is equivalent to an imaginary point load. If a beam is subjected to, or if there is UDL, this is 2 kN/m. For a length of 8 meter, this is equivalent to a point load, an imaginary point load of magnitude equal to intensity of UDL, that is 2, into the length over which it is distributed, and that equivalent imaginary point load will act at the midpoint of the UDL, that is 4 meter from this end or 4 meter from this end. Therefore, this is equivalent to an imaginary point load acting downward, 2 into 8. This 2 into 8, that is 16 kN. HA and HB will not come into sigma FY condition. Let us call that equation number 1. Now then, by applying sigma MA is equal to 0 here, it may be about this point, or it may be about this point you can take. You should consider the equilibrium of the whole arch, that is about A. If you take HA creates zero moment, VA creates zero moment, that is here, because perpendicular distance will be zero. Now this UDL acting down, equivalent point load, somewhere at 4 meter from here, it creates a moment like this about A, correct? Like this, clockwise. For plus 2 intensity of UDL into length of UDL, 2 into 8 into its perpendicular distance will be at mid length of UDL, means 4 meter from A, 4 meter, 8 by 2. Clockwise. Then coming to HB, it is acting, its line of action is passing through A, therefore no perpendicular distance, it will create zero moment, HB into zero. Then VB, about A, the turning tendency of VB will be like this, it is anti-clockwise. VB into, that is minus VB into its distance, that is full length, 20 meter. From this only one, it is VB, it can be found. That is, VB is equal to 3.2 kilonewton. If you substitute VA into equation 1, you get VA is equal to 12.8 kilonewton. Now to find one more unknown, we should apply sigma MC is equal to 0. Sigma MC, it is also an inch. Therefore, we can consider the free body diagram of the arch to the left of C, that is AB portion, AC portion, or to the right of C, that is CB portion. If you consider left side, HA, VA and this UDL will contribute to the algebraic sum of the moments. But if you consider right side, only HB and VB will contribute. Therefore, better if you consider right side of the moment center C, that is CB portion. If you consider right side, HB about C, it is acting like this, creating like this, it is clockwise. Plus HB into it, the line of action is here. This will be the perpendicular distance. Don't think this is the distance. Line of action HB is here. Perpendicular distance is this 4 meter. Therefore, HB into 4, it is clockwise. And VB about C, it is acting like this. It is creating a moment of this type about C. That is VB minus into its perpendicular distance. The line of action is here. About C means this will be the distance. Careful. In taking the distances of horizontal and vertical forces. This is the distance. Line of action. It is here. For this is the perpendicular distance. Nothing but this. Nothing but half span. That is 20 by 2. That is minus VB into 10. That is minus VB into 10 plus HB into 4 is equal to 0. From this, HB can be calculated. 8 kilonewton, nothing but HA, that is equal to H. Therefore, resultant reactions can be calculated. HA squared plus VA squared and the square root. This one. And inclination of the resultant reaction that we discussed in the last problem. Very clearly. In detail. 58 degrees. Similarly, resultant reaction at B will be this. And alpha B will be this. Okay. That is the resultant reaction. Okay. We'll discuss normal thrust and radial shear calculation in the next class.